bigots there are amongst us.
I call Alistair Scott.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Following on from Mr. Dunn's contribution, and endorse every word the man says, I'd like to... you're going to hear me say a few repetitive words, excessive and expensive. I'm going to say that a couple of times, and I'm also going to use the word credibility a number of times through the next few minutes, Mr. Speaker. Excessive and expensive are descriptive words of the opposition's policies. They should test, whenever they recommend a policy, to run it past an excessive, expensive test. Mr. Robertson suggested to us this afternoon that Labor Party policy, there is plenty of it, but he hasn't run it past the excessive and the expensive test. Now, if he had done so, he would find that he would reject half of the policies. It would help that side of the House gain credibility, something that we have on this side. We have oodles of credibility because, Mr. Speaker, our policies are practical, reasonable and affordable, in contrast to the excessive and expensive policies of the opposition. And they wonder why they poll at 20%. And it's because of the excessive and expensive policies. Now, I'm just going to give a couple of examples. Reflecting on Mr. Dunn's contribution just earlier, let's talk about immigration, the immigration policy enunciated by Mr. Little just a few weeks ago, saying that he wanted to cut immigration by 50,000 people. 50,000 people. Duncan Garner's show, it was all there in colour, black and white, 50,000 people. Now, that is just an excessive and expensive policy shooting from the hip. Excessive? How really is Mr. Little going to do that? Is he going to put up a wall to stop Kiwis coming home? Is he going to kill off the international student market, which is a multi-billion dollar industry? Is he going to stop students coming in from various countries on a working visa, filling gaps in our peak tourism seasons, which we, of course, have a reciprocal relation with other countries? Is he going to stop that from happening? Is he going to stop IT workers or engineers or project managers from coming into New Zealand? Because they are the people that we need to fill the gap to ensure that our economy continues to grow, continues to have opportunity for New Zealanders. So what is the answer? Is he? I tell you what, he's been listening to Mr. Twyford. He's going to stop Chinese-sounding named people from coming into New Zealand because he's got to do something to get 50,000 less people into New Zealand. An excessive and an expensive policy, which is just, I don't know how the other members of the opposition let him get away with it, because it does not make sense. I'm going to talk very quickly around a housing policy. 100,000 houses these guys are going to build, apparently. 100,000 houses. Contrast that with the practical, reasonable and affordable policy enunciated by Minister Adams just a few days ago, where 8,000 existing properties owned by Housing New Zealand will be turned into 34,000 houses. Now, Mr. Twyford, he wants to build 100,000. That is excessive and expensive. That's a $50 billion project. Now, remembering Mr. Twyford hates speculators and property investors.
That's right.
He keeps talking about them, talking what a poor job they are and what rip-off merchants they are. Yet he wants to be the largest one, the largest property investor, the largest speculator in the country, because he is going to have to go to the private sector to buy the land that he needs to build his 100,000 houses. And the effect of that will be higher prices in Auckland, across the country, for properties. Counterproductive, excessive and expensive. Mr. Speaker, I want to talk very quickly around the free tertiary education policy enunciated by the Labor Party. Again, that would mean that my parents could line up, get a free tertiary education on, I don't know, the history of tiddlywinks, funded by the taxpayer. Mr. Speaker, excessive and expensive and on that side, practical, reasonable and affordable on this.
Sorry, the member's time has expired. Members, the time for this debate has expired. Call on Government Order of the Day number 1.